Hi there. Welcome to this WordAmate tutorial. It will be divided into different sections and will handle all the basic stuff you need to create scenes and animations in WordAmate. This tutorial will not cover all the different aspects and settings, but it should give you a good base for further work on your skills. When you have loaded VAM and entered VR, you will find yourself in an empty black environment. The only objects here are the basic model and the menu panel. So let's have a look at the menu panel first. On top you have several buttons for the extended menus, called User Preferences, Main Menu, Scene Options and Selected Options, while the last tab is the one where you will spend most time in while configuring a scene. On the bottom there are the most important buttons, which allow you to select the Play and Edit mode. Edit mode must be activated to make bigger changes in the scene and to have access to all the options. Under Navigation you have buttons to enable teleport and free move modes, but I never use these, as you can activate the teleport with the touch on the 12 o'clock position of the touchpad. For all nearby movement I use the grab world functions on the 6 o'clock position on the touchpad. As you see, I have disabled the navigate lock height option, which allows me to drag the world freely in all directions. The player height adjustment changes the position of your head in relation to the real world floor. Freeze motion is a central point to stop all running animations in case you need to tweak some settings. Time scale allows to change overall speed for all movements, but there are other possibilities to achieve this, which you will see later. I never touch this one. The use of the possess buttons will be demonstrated later. On the right side you have the add atom section, which allows to add several new objects to the scene, will be explained later as well. Finally, world scale allows you to scale the whole environment around you. This is helpful to edit large-scale scenes, but also to create scenes with gigantic or tiny actors, like in the Gulliver's Travels novel. The description is a bit odd. To scale the world down, you need to increase the values. To make the world bigger, the value needs to be decreased. Alright, now let's jump into the extended menus. In the user preferences, you can adjust all kind of program settings. For instance, the performance tab allows you to adapt the quality settings to your system. I leave it usually on high, but I have not seen a big difference when I change it to ultra. Performance monitor opens an in-game display of the current frames per second. If activated, the cap physics updates option will limit the speed of animation and physics playback accordingly to your frame rate. This will make some heavy scenes play in slow motion, but on the other hand can prevent stuttering on weaker systems. The soft body physics are the main performance killer for me. Currently, VAM is very CPU bound to all the physics calculations which are done on the CPU level. But I still leave them on, as without you have only half the fun. You can fine-tune the standard profiles with the settings in the lower area. For the navigation panel there's not much to say, except if you use teleportation, you can choose whether it shall be possible to adjust the view direction at the target point by rotation of your controller. I try to demonstrate this now. Under the Controls tab there are some basic settings to select which way is preferred for the locomotion in VAM. As said before, I mainly use Grab World feature, which are shown now, and for bigger distances I use the teleport mode. The MISC tab has some additional settings, which to be honest I never touched. Well, except of the mirror to desktop feature, which allowed me to capture this video. Also, the Draw UI on top setting might be good to check out. It depends on personal taste, but I like to have the menu panel behaving like any other object in VAM. Means if it is behind another object, it should be hidden. Alright, let's check out the main menu. The new scene button will load the standard scene if you want to start again from scratch. The load built-in scene button loads the scenes which are provided with VAM. I think the amount of scenes here depend on the patron level. For the free version this is definitely limited. The load scene button is where the real fun starts. Here you can load all the community scenes once you have placed them in the VAM save folder. This button is not available in the free version of VAM. The Save Scenes button allows to save your own scene creations. The Screenshot mode allows to take, well, in-game screenshots. The Hard Reset button is a good help if VAM does not work like it should, for instance due to a messed up scene. It can prevent that the user needs to exit VAM completely. The last button exits the game. Okay, now for the Scene Options menu. Here it is possible to adjust overall scene illumination settings like Global Illumination Master or Camera Exposure Level. I usually leave all this as is and do everything with the lights in the scenes. The gravity settings have impact on the world gravity. So you could create a space scene with zero gravity if you play around with these. But now let's head over to a more interesting menu, which is the Scene Animation Master. Here you can select which controller nodes are enabled for record, you can start and stop record modes, allow the playback to loop endlessly, show the timeline and so on. And in the Edit tab, you can cut the recorded animation based on your needs. So, wait, too fast? No worry, I will cover this later in detail in the Record Animation section. Like I said initially, the Selected Options tab is the most important one and it gives access to all the objects or atom-specific settings of each item in VAM. Persons, lights, environments, animation patterns, everything. To get into the Settings tab for each object, you need to activate it first. To do so, slightly touch the right side, it's the 3 o'clock position of the touchpad to show the green control nodes of the existing objects. In case of the person, the icon looks like a human, but each atom type has a different icon. Once activated, you have access to all its settings over the Selected Options button. On top of the menu is the name of the atom. In this case, it's person. If you click on a different atom node, the complete menu content changes to display the needed settings. Usually the pink tab contains the very specific settings and the other tabs like control, move, physics and animation have common layout for all atom types. The last point of the menu panel is the Add Atom section. Here you are able to add several new atoms to the scene. First, you want to select the atom type, which can be anything from basic geometry like cubes, over animations and cycle force controllers up to full environments. Then you click the button Add Object to load the selected item into the scene. As you see, we have now a full environment loaded around our character. One final hint for the menu panel. If you need info about the control scheme of your controller hardware, you can find this over the Control Help button on the right side. There is one more thing to discuss about the user interface, as it does not end at the menu panel. I mentioned it earlier, but each object in the scene has a controller icon which you can see if you touch the thumb pad on the right side. The big pictogram icons are the main controllers for the atoms, and the smaller green and red cubes are the control nodes for the different body parts of the character model. The difference and function of those cubes will be covered in the next video. Objects without own functionality are marked with a green rectangle. If you target the laser pointer over the controller nodes, their names are displayed conveniently. So, that's it for the user interface introduction. See you in the next video about character posing and basic rigging.